Now, I would like to get an honor to introduce our respected Dr. Shibra Sanyal, ma'am. Ma'am is a former counselor at OHBII Seva Kutir, New Delhi, and former senior reader at National Institute of Criminology and Forensic Science, MHA, New Delhi. She has undergone training on direct training skills and designing of training by ISMT and addictive behavior among adolescents, drug users, and women empowerment. She started her career as a lecturer in Isabella Thoburn College, Lucknow, and she has also worked as a lecturer in psychology in Jail Officers Training School, Lucknow. Ma'am was a senior faculty member at the National Institute of Criminology and Forensic Science. She has worked as a deputy director at the National Institute of Social Defense and head of the Drug Bureau, and as a deputy director for behavioral training in the Institute of Secretariat Training and Management. After her retirement, she is actively busy in many research work like national research on rehabilitation of released prisoners in India, for which she has awarded the Jawaharlal Nehru Memorial Fellowship. She is the author of many books, including Save Your Children, written for NCERT, and Communication and Counseling in the Workplace. Ma'am has been part of many national and international seminars and conferences and went abroad to attend various training courses. She has been honored with the Sushil Chandra Award by the All India Association of Criminology for her work in training and research. With this, I would like to hand over this session to Respected Shibra Sanyal, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And before I start sharing my views on communication, I would like to thank Dr. Ranjit and his team for actively coming forward and sharing my ideas and views. And he promptly, that is a very sporting spirit he has, which I really recognize, I acknowledge, and I respect. That he immediately said that, ma'am, we'll do it. Because I was thinking that this communication on which I have written the book should be focused, should be brought to the public, and should be shared with everyone. So thank you at the outset to Dr. Ranjit and team members. And I think I look forward. That gives me a satisfaction that even at this age, I'm able to share my ideas that I have stored with you people. Thank you once again.
Thank you so much.
Now, I've slightly become emotional, Dr. Ranjit, I've slightly become emotional. Just give me 1 minute time. Because emotion is again part of communication and that correlates. So I need one time. You have really supported me. Thank you, Dr. Ranjit, and we hope that in future we will be working together in this manner.
Definitely.
Now coming, sorry?
Definitely, ma'am, and thank you so much for all your achievement and sharing your knowledge, agree to sharing your knowledge with a lovely participant. And I'm sure that we all need to develop our communication at every stage and experience people like you, those who are going to guide us to develop the communication is going to be, I'm sure that it's going to be a fabulous 3 days. Thank you so much, ma'am. And we all are agree that we are starting our new year with some new motto to develop our effective communication.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Thank you. So now I would like to share that a few things from the book that I have written on communication and counseling in the workplace. And I would like to mention here words or statements you can say that my former director, Mr. Sharda Prasad, I have informed him also, had written about the, particularly about the workplace, the culture, the communication, and why is it that many an organizations do not rise because of the lack of communication between the boss and the employee. He had readily mentioned here that along with the work culture, that there should be a proper interaction between the employees and the bosses, and there should be a positive feedback which will enrich not only the culture of the workplace, but will also enrich the learning of the employees, will enrich the motivation of the employees. And this is all based on a positive communication. So from here, I go ahead and I mention here that when we talk of the word communication, that means we are communicating. Now, if I break the words into bits, then it comes to communicate. Now, communication, we do it to our own self when we're talking to our own self. Communication positively moves, then that very self that we are speaking within goes to another person. So there is a sender and a receiver. Now, before I show you the paradigm, how encoding and decoding takes place, let me share with you one thing, that communication is the baseline, you can say the lifeline of every individual. Before I move to an organization, we will be having many speakers who will be talking about organizations, the CEOs will be talking about organizations, there will be people talking about personality correlates of communication. Let me share with you here in a broader manner that it leads, you know, right from the day a child is born, he starts crying, he wants food. Once he's fed, he goes to sleep. That very child, as he grows, his communication reforms, multiplies, and it adapts to a given situation. He learns. This is how we say the personality development takes place. He learns how to communicate, how to appease, and sometimes it so happens that his communication may be fake. He is telling lies. It can go in the negative direction also. But the learning process has to be so tuned that his communication should be in a proper manner. That is the beginning of communication in a person. But as we move ahead, let me share with you that this very communication, many a times it gets distorted. Many a times, you know, this communication also leads to domestic violence. This communication on many times, you know, it is sometimes ends up in a fraudulent behavior. Because communication, by and large, as an individual grows, you have to accept that it gets related to the individual self. And when we talk about the individual self, that means it gets related to the individual's intelligence, to his personality, to his emotions, to his ideas and interests, and to his attitude. So every individual has a personality formation, and along with it, let me share with you, and there will be speakers sharing with you again, that we all have an ego. That ego is the self. Who am I? And this who am I again relates to the other person who says, who am I? There's a question mark. And then from that ego, this is all related to communication. I'm okay, you're not okay. Now, a person who feels I'm okay, you're not okay, will immediately move in an aggressive communication, try to correct the other person. The communication style will be different. A person who says, I'm not okay, you're okay, will, you know, take up a very submissive communication. Yes, I agree with you. I think I should listen to you. Another person will say, if I'm not okay, you're not okay, he will immediately know whatever the age is. He will say, okay, you are in a habit of saying this. Now, this is shortcut communication. And this can happen everywhere. I'm happening at home. The moment I talk, my husband says, keep quiet. I know what you're saying. Because he's talking from his mindset without listening to what a person has to say. Now, here I come to the next aspect, the listening. Communication, basic dynamic is listening. How many people listen to each other? Why don't we listen to each other? Because we at once feel that that person opposite me is going to say this. As a result, the communication becomes shortcut. The communication becomes miscommunication. The communication leads to communication gap. And as a result, what happens? There's lack of understanding, no listening, only hearing, and voices are being heard, words are not being noticed. So friends, what I'm trying to share with you, that we till we die, we go on communicating, But how many communications are really ending up with a positive result? Very few. We talk of stress. What is the stress? This stress is self-created. This stress is all the time a feeling that probably the person is not understanding me. Probably, you know, I'm not able to go across and talk. These are stress. So my basic objective, when I spoke to Dr. Ranjit and I said we should go with this, is to send a message to the whole society. Society means all the spectrums, all the sectors of the society, that whether they are corporate sectors, whether they are family setups, whether they are with students, teacher-student relationship, whether this is parents and children, or A plus B, one-to-one. Everywhere, we have to understand the other person. And for that, you know, we need what? There are again tips of communications coming, which I'll come later. We need to have patience. We need to have perseverance. We need to listen and then react. I won't say react also. I'll correct myself. I'll say respond. Now, when we talk of, therefore, let me say, of course, you know what happens. One person may be having very positive. I'm one. I can share with you that I'm having a very good communication with others. You know, I think and I talk. But in personal life, maybe, you know, somewhere I'm emotionally disturbed. And I said, kya baat hai? Hame nahi sunna hai. You know, what is that? That is a negative emotion. A sane person who is very positively oriented in the workplace, having a very good relationship with his boss and with his co-colleagues and with his subordinates and working well, may not be that good at home. It is ironical because he cannot carry, you know, the moment he comes to home, he's relaxed. And he feels people must listen to him, whatever he says, because he's doing that in the office. But the home setup is different. Here the wife says, I'm okay, you're not okay. I'm taking care of the home. I'm taking care of your children. And here you're coming and showing me your bossism. So, you know, this thing, a person who has a stable mind, who has a very sound personality, who knows what to say, when to say, why to say, how to say, that person will be able to have a set of communication in the workplace and a different set of communication in at home. Then only the harmony can be managed. Now, I ask Aarti or Kritika, there's a paradigm I have sent, you know, on the process of communication. Can you show it? Can you show it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Yeah. Where is the paradigm? Yeah. Now, if you all just expand it a little, thoda sa badha do. I think I have to open my... Yeah. Now, if you look at it, all of you, you will find that I have got it in my book also. I'll share with you the address of my book. You can get it. There I have sent up, you know, encoding, decoding process. Anywhere and everywhere. Whenever we are talking, or let's say we are communicating, there has to be a sender and a receiver. When you move out of yourself and you start talking, you start recording, what are you doing? You are at the moment encoding. And this encoding, the message, it goes to the receiver who decodes the message and then analyzes the message and then sends it back to the sender. At this moment, I'm doing exactly the same thing. I am one sitting here. I am encoding a message. That is the process of communication. And I'm not seeing those who are decoding. Now, everybody has their own style, own way, own of conceiving, understanding, because understanding also depends on your own interest, on your background of knowledge, on how you perceive it. So you will be decoding in differently in the same class. You're sitting in the same place you're sitting, but you're decoding in a different manner. One person may say, what ma'am is saying, this is all I know. Other person may say, well, this is of no need to me. Third person may say, well, this is something I should understand. So these are the various patterns of receptivity. And this receptivity depends on the analysis, then how the person is analyzing. And then it comes back to the sender. Now, you know, I want to make a point here. In a government organization, I have worked in a government organization. I worked under different supervisors. They were all in the rank of police. And I can place them in different forms. When a boss and an officer in the workplace waits for the feedback from the employees or the subordinates and finds that what he wanted is coming back to him, you can understand that he is a leader and not a boss. He gets satisfaction because he's getting the positive feedback. He's getting the feedback what he wanted. So this whole circle that it shows that encoding and decoding is the process of communication. It is the life skill of communication. It is the baseline of communication. You can put it in any form. Without a proper analysis and without a proper feedback, communication, believe me, friends, it remains a failure. In my words, it remains a failure. It creates tension. It creates mishaps anywhere and everywhere in the society, in the world. Communication put in the right manner, perceived in the right manner, understood in the right manner, and sent back in the right manner is right. And that reminds me of the word right, right. One of my colleagues will be joining you, Mr. Casey Ghosh, if he's hearing me. This word right, right, when I was in ISTM, he generated in my mind. W-R-I-T-E, right, R-I-G-H-T, right. These two words are so synonymous in sounding, but they are two different at poles apart. You write right when you write in the right spirit, with the right message, at the right time to the right person. Then it is right, W-R-I-T-E, R-I-G-H-T, right. What happens in the organizations? What happens in the workplace? What happens in government organization or in private? A file starts moving, I'll tell you the process. And a person with all aspiration writes that I want to take up this research proposal or I want to do this work, and the file goes up. When the file goes up to the director, he says, okay, look into these following things, done. Immediately the person, the subordinate, does it and sends again. Now it is going through a process to the clerks, to the desk officer, to assistant, from the assistant director, finally it goes to the director. Then after a lot of crisscross, red lines, blue lines, all lines, the file is turned down saying, file it, you know? This is an official language. F-I-L-E, file, becomes the language, file it, that means close it. It becomes a frustration. Without, there is no conversation. This is communication of North Pole and South Pole meeting, not meeting anywhere. This is a negative aspect of the workplace, where you will find, as a result, that many a people in the workplace, either they leave the job, or if they're forced to work in there, they become malingerers. They do not work. In government space, we have so many malingerers. In the private, people can leave and go. The employee has to be motivated, should be having inspiration. He is creative. He wants to bring out his talent, which will finally help in the growth of the organization. This book that I have written, before this paradigm you have seen, you will find in the top of the book, I'll give it, there's the word saying, be a leader and not a boss. Again, it comes for the CEOs, for the people in the corporate sectors, for government organizations. It says, the boss drives the men, the leader inspires them. The boss depends on authority, the leader on goodwill. I'll just skip over and I'll say, that they say the boss knows how it is done, the leader shows how to do it. The boss demands respect, the leader commands respect. And these are all on the psychodynamics of communication. Because even if, you know, if the boss moves away, you people who are, having knowledge of these communication, the corporate will know that there's a pyramid. The pyramid shows that the leader, the boss is there and the follower is there. The moment the boss falls, the whole team goes down. But if the leader is from the back, he's a pusher. He's pushing the team up. So even if he moves away from the back, the team is still moving up. I think Dr. Ranjit will agree with me, and all his your friends will agree with me, that if you want to develop your organizations, lots of talents are in your organization. Try to bring them out and put them in. Now, I want to go to the second paradigm, that is the four W's, which I have mentioned in my book and which I've created it, if that can be shown. Aarti?
Ma'am, it's there on the screen.
Yeah. You know, that is to whom you're speaking, why you're speaking, when are you speaking, where are you speaking, and how are you speaking. Now, how has been added by me? The four W's, of course, I got it from a book. Now, you know what happens? As I mentioned a little bit earlier, that in the when you're in the office setup and you're talking to a person, whom you're talking. When you're talking to your boss, you're talking in a different language. In the police sectors, I know because I had been interacting with the police right from 1984 till now, and even in 74, I was with the correctional officers. They have only one word, yes, sir. They never say no, sir, because they dare not say no, sir, when they speak to the boss. Later, they may come out and they will say how to do it. This boss is a fool. They may say anything about the boss, but they will dare not say to the boss, no, sir. The moment they come out, talk to the subordinates, they will say, go ahead and do it. This has to be done. This is a communication in a vertical manner. Yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir, right from the ground, from the cutting edge level, that's the constable and below, to the DG, it is yes, sir. It has to be done. But there have been very good police officers, I know, who had also been ready to hear the no, sir. And they loved those who said, sir, we can do it sometime afterwards. Listen to us. They have listened. And they have developed. They have become popular. Police stress comes, or any corporate sector, stress comes when this vertical communication of yes, sir, goes up. Now, this very man who is saying yes, sir, to his boss. I'm setting an example to you all. We come to the next. When he comes to his house, he's coming from office with a lot of frustration. And the moment his wife says, let's put a common example, thoda bazaar jaake kuch sabzi le aoge, no. Now here comes the no. Why no? Because he is stressed. He is frustrated. He is tired and fatigued. He doesn't know how to move work in that workplace. So he says no. Now, why did he say no? Because he is the same person who has undergone frustration. Now he is in his house, he thinks, I'm the boss now. So I can boss. And he bosses over his wife. When he returns, where, at home, and how, the language. How is a denominator? I give you another example. That a guest comes, an unwanted guest, untimely you can say, or maybe not a very important guest, an ordinary guest. Guest is a guest. He comes in, you meet him, and you sit with him. Now this is whom, why, when, and where. He has come to your house. Who has come? A guest whom you have not expected, or guest whom you think not very important. Maybe a family member also. And where? At your home. Now, what? How? You say, बैठिए हम आपका सादर हम आप बैठ रहे हैं आपके पास. यू डोंट इवन ऑफर हिम ए कप ऑफ टी. लेटर व्हेन ही इज अबाउट टू लीव हाउ आर यू एक्सपेक्टिंग हिम दैट हाउ कम्स यू टॉक इन अ वेरी ग्लॉसी लैंग्वेज यू टॉक एवरीथिंग टू हिम द मोमेंट ही लीव्स देन यू से एक कप चाय पी के जाते. Why did you not offer the chai before? Why did you say, ek glass pani pi lijiye? Now this is not a, what should I put in? In a good spirit, the communication. The man has understood if he's intelligent that he was not welcome in that house. Message goes. He may not convey back the feedback to you, but later, he may not contact you. He may distance himself from you. And therefore, this how should be taken care. You can put 4 W's on the top. But this 4 W's will crumble if your how is weak. Like I say, that when we talk of ego, superego, id, ego, superego. You know, superego in the personality is a socialization process. Where a person's personality gets built up, what others will think about me. And the moment this, what others think about me, weakens, I say, damn care what others think about me. Then the id on the top starts working. And id is nothing else but the animal-like behavior where we lose all control over our emotions, over all our wishes and all. We become wild. As a result, what happens that today when you notice terror, when you're noticing aggression, when you're noticing riot, when you're noticing protest, you open your TV, you open your YouTube, you open any channels, you'll find that there are all the time protests, riots. Now, who are these people? There is also communication going on. Please understand, this is not a distorted communication. This is not a broken communication. When you talk of a crowd is one where there is no, you know, identity, anonymity prevails. When the crowd becomes a mob, then an aggression starts showing. And when there's a group, there's an organized communication. So even if a protest is taking place, there is some leader who is invisible and hiding somewhere. But he has conveyed all the instructions. Modus operandi is being followed and protest takes place. I'm not mentioning anything political, but you people can get the message I'm conveying. So this is what, you know, communication can be distorted. It can go to the unhealthy condition of the country. It can go to the disruption and negative development. It can, if you take it to the other end, it can again, you know, become positive, development, growth, happiness, harmony. Both sides are there. So we must take care of these 4 W's and what 4 W's divided by how. How are we placing this? In what environment we are placing it. These things should be taken care. Now, I want to share, you know, there will be speakers here, of the personality correlates with communication. We have in our personality, introversion and extroversion. These are two personality traits. One can be extrovert. He has a socialization process. He talks. Other is an introvert who also talks, but talks less, moves in smaller circles, has his own priorities and choices, and does not make friends very often. But friends, now if you observe, you all who are students, if you observe in yourself and in others, you will find that an introvert, even if he's not communicating, he's listening to you intently. And then he comes back afterwards when you finish. When an extrovert may stop you in the midway and will start talking because he cannot wait for you to finish. He wants to say that is part of his personality. So communication exercises, if you're given or if you're doing or people are there, you will find that personality correlates very closely and significantly with communication. So I cannot, as a psychologist, expect that everyone has to be adaptable, everyone has to be cooperative, everyone, no. For that reason, when one person is talking, I have to listen to him, understand him, and place him in where he is. There comes again the 4 W's. To whom I'm talking, why I'm talking, when I'm talking, and where I'm talking. Suppose I point a finger, body language, you know. Communications again are of many types. We have verbal communication, we have non-verbal communication. We have written communication. Body language is there, sign communication. Now I point a finger, you know, this body language, there are 4 fingers we are pointing to me and 1 finger is going to another person, which shows an authoritarian attitude. There you are. I may not say, just finger there. That shows that you are wrong, I'm right. So these things have to be kept in mind, whether we are in the workplace or in the home or in the ground or in the sports. These things are being trained. Leadership qualities has to be, you know, has to contain the listening skill. There are certain, you know, tips of communication process. The tips, cues, you can see. The cues are that be patient when another person is talking, no matter how irritant you're feeling. Be a patient listener also. Listen. Very specific to your points you communicate so that the message goes, like, for example, I disagree. Now, where you're saying, that depends on you. Next is, when you are talking, communicating, again, be specific, brief, short, to the point. But listening skill has to be there. Counselors are trained to listen. I always, even when I was speaking to many a counselors in Amity or anywhere, I used to say that never counsel when you are mentally upset, because we all have a background behind us. We all have our own behind us. We have a family behind us. We have our own personality, our mindset. Not interested to counsel. Do not counsel. Stay put. But please do not become subjective when you're counseling. Aha, as for the mere saath bhi hua tha, you thought in your mind, and whatever you said, aap drugs le lo. You will be fine. A counselor telling a patient, go ahead and take drugs. This is disastrous. So every point, if we listen, you know, if you go through these processes, that's why, you know, we have spelled out this program for you all, that you listen carefully and put yourself in it and say, where I'm lacking. What do I learn from this? What should I do to improve my communication? And of course, we are giving you question answer session. You can place your questions as many as you want. Now, I have one other paradigm which I want to show. I don't know what time I am taking against anybody. Kritika, mujhe bataogi na? Kitna time hai mere paas?
Yes, ma'am.
I have time?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then you show me the third one.
Now, ma'am, we have half more hour to cover.
Half an hour?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, fine, fine. I want to give them time for question answer also. I don't want to be one traffic, one side, you know. Chal rahe hai to chal rahe hai. I want there.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
To ask questions. So now, you know, what I want others to see, you know, this, thoda sa isko bada karna hai. I can't see it. Yahan se dekhna hoga. Dikhai de rahe ki dekh sabko? People can see it. Okay, I can't see. It is about the likes and dislikes of a supervisor. Now, there is a supervisor who is dangerous and helpful. Now, please note, all of you, he's dangerous, but he's helpful. Another one below is dangerous, but not helpful. Now, go to the other side. The person is non-dangerous, but helpful. And the lastly is one who is non-dangerous and non-helpful. Now, if you put these in the column of communication, you will find a person who is dangerous, but he's helpful. That means He's a father-like figure. He's a father-like figure who has a protective outlook, whose supervisory skill is so good that he says, I am a task-oriented person. I'm workaholic. I need work. Give me within a week, he tells his subordinates. The subordinate, in the meantime, maybe due to his personal problems, maybe his disability to complete the work, illness at home, whatever the problems, he comes forward to say, sir, give me another few days. I'll complete and give it. This officer, no matter how dangerous is, he'll come down and ask, kya hua hai tumhare saath? Kya problem hai? You are such a good person. And then he listens and he says, okay, go ahead, helpful. I'll give you a case to you here. This was expressed to me, shared with me during my time tenure when I was in ISTM. An officer, you can say a supervisory officer or maybe of the rank of joint director or something, was having a very good assistant with her. All of a sudden, the assistant stopped coming. You know, absenteeism is another minus point of progress in work. It is a sign of dislike, disagreement with the supervisor, non-interest in the work done, and a sign of laziness. Now here, this case came. The lady all of a sudden felt the assistant was just, you know, dropping in and out very often. Absenteeism was going up. She was watching, she was correcting, but he was not listening to her. One day, he stopped coming. She went on inquiring, and she found that he's not coming these days. As a result, the files were pending on the table. So she said, okay, give me the address, I'll go to the house. She went, and she found him. The mother was, he was not married. The mother was very disturbed. He said, he hardly comes out of the room. He just sits there and is smoking away. She went to him, called him aside, made him sit next to him, listen to my punning words. Generally, we sit across the table, but she went and sat next to him. He was stunned to see her in his house. And she asked him, kya baat hai? Kya problem hai? Samjhao. And then when he gave his list of problems, very genuine ones, then she said, okay, you take your time and come back. And that man was a changed man. It happens everywhere. These very big companies that we come across, they have these people like that. They have, the CEOs are trained to bring forth the inner talent of a person. The person not able to do it himself, bring it out. So he is dangerous, but he is helpful. We go to the next person. Who is dangerous but not helpful? That is, again, we go to the lifestyle of an individual. I'm okay, you're not okay. You will find this in the police. You will find in the defense. Now, defense people told me, man, we believe in discipline. Discipline has to be the first priority of ours. And I remember when I used to take classes of the CRPF, even in CBI, the moment I entered, they used to sit straight with their hands on their legs and at ease, which used to make me very uncomfortable because I'm an academic person. And I used to tell them, relax, relax, relax your shoulder, relax your ear, because I knew that the more they are tense, they are not listening to me. And they should relax. So, ye unka jo hai, वो कहेंगे पुलिस वाले डिफेंस की ये तो हमारा काम है हमें करना है वी हैव टू टेक ऑर्डर्स वी हैव टू हैव डिसिप्लिन फर्स्ट बिहाइंड आई विल नरेट अ केस टू यू अगेन हियर व्हेन आई वाज डेवलपिंग द रैपिड एक्शन फोर्स कोर्स रैपिड एक्शन फोर्स इज अ कोर्स है अब उस समय काफी दिन पहले आई अलोंग विथ माई टीम वी वर कलेक्टिंग डेटा एट झरदा कलान 10,000 पीपल वी इंटरव्यूड They were all at the commando levels, constables. And then later, I was called by the DG CRPF and said, ma'am, we have given you trained people now from CRPF. They were getting recruited into RAF, Rapid Action Force. And the Rapid Action Force has different set of instructions. They are not given proper arms and ammunition. They don't have sticks, they have rubber rods, bullets with rubber balls, these sort of thing. And but there's no tolerance, Rapid Action Force. So they called me and said, ma'am, we have trained and we have recruited. Now what next? I said, give me the commandos for training. So they understood my message. That was my form of communication. And why I could say, because I was an expert from outside. I was sent by MHA to talk to them. So I could speak. And that is part of my personality also, my dear friends. I'm fortunate, God blessing, that I speak. I always believe, I always tell my, told my students wherever and everywhere, never say yes when you want to say no. Many people came to me and said, ma'am, it is very easy for you to say, but for us difficult. I said, I understand. But you have different type of communication. You can say, sir, give me some time to find out. Or I beg to disagree. If you find your boss of a democratic nature, he will listen to you. But rather than say yes, and you're not able to do, is the biggest failure for you. Now we go to the next, and that is, they're non-dangerous, but they're helpful. Now, non-dangerous helpful are the very, very good people. I've also come across non-dangerous and helpful. They don't write your CR in a negative manner. They don't scold you and throw you out. They respect your self-respect. They respect your dignity. They respect your talent. They give importance to your skill. They are always ready to help you. And that is how we grow. When an individual is growing, my friends, the organization is also growing. When organization is growing, then production is coming out good. You know, this thing, sale productions are coming. And I believe, you know, that the country grows when the society grows. So these people who are non-dangerous helpful are the really democratic people, and they believe in the concept of I'm okay, you're okay. We come to the last one, and I place the last one because they are redundant, and it's better that no organization has these type of people. They are non-dangerous, but they are not helpful also. Ataram, Gayaram, Jayaram type of people who will say, okay, you go. As long as they are there, they are working for the sake of their own self. All the scams, I don't bite words, Dr. Ranjit, I don't bite words. All the scams that are happening in very big organizations, multinational organizations in the country, they are of this type. Who are, you know, they just come for their own sake and they go away when their work is finished. They do not care for the organization, for the industry, for the employees, for the production, for the investment. They simply care for themselves. And I'm now, you know, finally at this stage, I'm becoming sure with all these scams that are going on, that these people with their money in Swiss banks and different banks, they are secured financially. So even if they get imprisoned in any jail, they don't matter. They have very good advocates, they'll get the bail and they will come out. These are the people who should not be fit enough to come into any corporate sectors. I am very sorry to say, my talk may be very loud, but this is true. This is a negative, negative and negative to the growth of the industry, of the factory, for the people and for the nation as a whole. So I think with this, you know, I am now completing my thing. There are cases